boys and girls. I'm happy to see you today. Look what I have, a basket with some coins. This basket usually sits near my library desk. Sometimes people put money in the basket so the library can buy new books. My friend, Detective Dave, is with me today to help me count the coins.
Let's count. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. We have seven coins. Will that be enough to buy a new book?
We don't have enough coins yet. Maybe someone will drop more money in the basket. When I get enough coins, I can buy a new book for the library. These coins remind me of a Bible story about King Joash. Would you like to hear it? Oh, good. I like telling you Bible stories. Joash was 7 years old when he became king, and he reigned 40 years in Jerusalem. Wow! Joash became the king when he was 7 years old. That's not much older than some of you. King Joash loved God and did what was right. After Joash grew up, he decided to do some work on the temple. The temple was a place where people went to worship God. Joash gathered all the temple helpers and told them to go into the cities. "Hurry, go collect silver from the people so we can repair the temple," Joash told them. The helpers did not do what the king asked. They didn't hurry. So, the king had another idea. At the king's command, a chest was made and placed outside the gate of the Lord's temple. The king had a large box put outside the temple. He announced that the people should bring their offerings and place them inside the box. Each day, the people went to the temple and dropped in their offerings. The people were happy to give. Soon, the box was completely full. Many people worked hard to repair the temple. There were workers who cut stone, built with wood, and worked with metal. King Joash used some of the people's offerings to pay the workers. Soon, the temple was finished. The people went to the temple and worshiped God. Joash and the people showed their love for God by giving offerings. They gave money to pay the workers who repaired the temple.
People give offerings at church today, too. Giving money helps the church do God's work.
That's right, Detective Dave. You can give an offering at church, too. Some churches have shiny plates for people to put their offerings. Other churches have baskets, boxes, or envelopes where people can give money. Sometimes people give offerings by using a phone or a computer.
People obey and honor God when they give offerings. Giving money at church is a way to worship God and show your love for Him.
People give money at church to help others learn about God and Jesus. Some of the money even helps people go and tell about Jesus in other parts of the world. Thanks for being such great listeners. I hope you'll think about what you've heard today. Maybe you can give an offering to help the people in your town hear about Jesus. Come again soon!
I was made.